hope when you take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you built a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad.
It's me, Jordan. This is my 14th year playing softball and my 6th year playing maroon tight softball. And I have been number 9 the last 4 years. My plans for the future are to eventually become a doctor after attending med school. I would like to thank our coaches for coaching me and being along this journey with me. I started playing softball for Picayune at 13. And I am now 18, and it has been 6 very unforgettable years, and I've had the time of my life. To the seniors, I want to say good luck to all of you. All of us are going to go on different paths, and we might not see each other for years. Hopefully not, but I just wish you guys luck and hope that you guys' future is amazing, is great. You guys have been 3 best friends, 3 sisters. I've played with Morgan for years and Brooke and Mary Beth. I've had so much fun playing with you two as well. And to the rest of the team, I mean, I will always be y'all's number one supporter. If you guys need any help, I will always be here. You guys know my phone number. And I just want to say that you guys are amazing. Y'all can do anything. I mean anything, if you guys put your minds to it. The growth that I've seen, especially from our littles, the last couple of months going to workouts has been amazing. And I just know that you guys are going to accomplish big goals in the future. Bye.
Hope when the moment comes, you'll say,
I'm the daughter of Amy and the late Ralph Bro, sister to Dylan Bro, and stepsister to Remy Fulce. I've been playing softball since I was 5 years old, and this was my 6th and final season playing with the Lady Tide. After this year, I plan to attend PRCC in the fall and start off by getting my basics and then pursuing a career into physical therapy. Now, I'd like to thank all the people that has helped me along the way on my journey. First off, I'd like to start by thanking my mom for all that she's done for me and for always being there when I need her the most. But most of all, I want to thank her for always sitting in the crazy weather and the bugs, which we all know that she hates, to support me and cheer me on doing what I love the most. Thank you for all the countless hours you spent at the softball field since I was a little girl. Mama, your strength is so inspiring, and I want you to know that I love you and I'm so very proud of you. Next, I would like to thank my big brother, Dylan. You have been my best friend since day one, and I'm so very thankful for all that you do for me and support me in all that I do. Thank you for coaching me, being tough on me, and helping me since I was a little girl. Thank you for being the best big brother, Bubby. I'll always look up to you, and I love you very much. To Kate, Lance, and Remy, thank y'all for always supporting me and always being there for me. Remy, I'm thankful for the time that we got to play together, and now I can't wait to watch you play and do big things. To Jay, thank you for coming to support me and cheer me on these past few years. It really means a lot. Thank you for always... for what you do and for always pushing me to be my best. I saved the best for last, to my sweet daddy. Thank you for being my coach since the first time I stepped onto a softball field. Thank you for always being tough on me, pushing me to be my best, and always supporting me in everything that I did. Thank you for all the countless hours you spent at the softball fields with me since I was little and always coaching me. This season, I really missed hearing your voice behind that fence coaching me. But I know that you are right there on the field with me, taking every step and every play with me. And I want you to know that I love you and that I miss you very much, and I'm going to keep making you proud. To Coach Christie, thank you for molding me into the player I am today and for always pushing me to be the best player and person I could possibly be. I'm thankful for everything that you've done for me on and off the field. I know this season wasn't what we hoped for, but God has big things in plan for us. To Coach Courtney, thank you for always pushing me, helping me behind the plate, and always being there for me. To Coach Hill, thank you for being goofy with me, helping me in a lot, and for always being there for me. Lastly, my amazing teammates. Thank y'all for all the amazing memories, crazy bus rides, and all the TikTok dances in the locker room. I'm going to miss y'all very much. Play hard and be grateful for every moment at the Mitch, because it doesn't last forever. I love y'all, and I'm going to miss y'all.
Hope that you spend your days, but they all add up. I'll say,
school. I'm our student body president this year, and I've been an athletic trainer for 2 years now, and I'm involved in many clubs and organizations. I plan on attending Ole Miss in the fall to major in exercise science. I would like to start off by thanking the good Lord above for making all of this possible, for giving me the breath in my lungs each morning to wake up and to be able to have the opportunity to play softball. There's been trials and errors, but in the end, all the glory goes to Him. I would like to thank my mother for being my number one fan my entire life, for always being at every single one of my games, and for pushing me to be the best version of myself that I can be each day. I love you, Mom. I would like to thank my grandparents for always being there for me and to remind me that the low points do not define you, that there are higher points in life, and I am thankful for all that you do. It does not go unnoticed. I would like to thank some coaches that started the love of the game for me at a young age, beginning at the travel ball level, moving up. A huge shout out to Coach Dawn, Miss Jenny Millwood, Chris Smith, and Jordan Wainwright. Thank you guys for giving a small little girl a chance and for originating MERT. Means a lot. Thank you, Coach Courtney, for all you are. You are a shining star. Your encouragement has meant the world, and you have taught me a lot on the softball field. Coach Hillary, I thank you for our first base talks, you always reminding me that I am a good athlete and not to get hard on myself. I'm thankful for you too. Coach Christie, I can't even begin to thank you for all that you've done, not just for me, but for our program. I am thankful to call you coach, and I know that you're going to do great things in the future. I am thankful for your guidance in reminding me that I'm not the one in control, and that when I do try to control things on my own, that it's not going to end the way that it should, because it's the Lord's plan and not my own. I'm thankful for all that you've taught me on the softball field. It has pushed me to be who I am today. You have impacted me greatly. I love you, Coach. I would also like to thank Annie Bowe and Miss Rebecca Rucks for being the number one supporters during my ACL journey junior year, in order to put me back on the softball field my senior year. I am thankful for my teammates. You guys are sisters to me. You will always be sisters to me. Teammates can teach you more than anyone can in the midst of playing the game. And I am so thankful to have been able to play the game with you guys. You guys are going to do amazing things in life. Keep your heads up. I love you all. I just want to say, Roll Tide, and that I am thankful to forever be a Lady Tide softball player. 18 years.
I saw so many places, the things that I did. swear I lived.
Dickerson. I am the daughter of Tony and Vicky Dickerson. This is my sixth year with the Lady Todd softball program as number 17. I will be attending PRCC hoping to pursue my career in cosmetology. I want to start off first by thanking my mom and dad for always supporting me and always doing their best to make it to every single game. Dad, thank you for the countless hours spent in the front yard and at the ballpark, teaching me how to pitch from YouTube and helping me improve my hitting and my fielding. Mom, thank you for washing my uniforms, and thank you for telling me when I'm not doing my best because you know I have more in me. To my brothers, thank you for always coming to my games even if you didn't want to. To Coach Courtney, thank you for teaching me everything I needed to know about hitting and helping me improve my fielding. To Coach Hillary, thank you for helping me improve my pitching from the very beginning, and thank you for teaching me more pitches when I needed them. To Coach Christie, thank you for everything you do, not only for the team, but for every individual person. Thank you for all the effort you put in on and off the field. Thank you for pushing me to do more than what I was giving because you know I had it in me. Next, I would like to thank my teammates for always being there for me. I'm going to miss game days and messing around in the locker room. Last but not least, Brooke, Mert, and Jordan. Thank you for all the great memories we have together. Brooke, thank you for always catching for me and all the many conversations we had in the bullpen. Mert, thank you for all the encouragement you give and for being crazy with me. Jordan, thank you for all the talks we had at third base and in the outfield. I'm going to miss playing ball with y'all. I wish we could play one last game together, but God had other plans for us. I love all of you, and I'm going to miss you all.
Oh, I owned every second that this world could give. I saw so many places, the things that I did. There was every broken. I swear I live. I swear I live.
Good evening, Marine Tide Nation. Coach Christy Mitchell of Marine Tide Softball, coming to you from the Mitch. Today's date, April 20th of 2020. Tonight would have been our last regular season softball game, and we would be looking forward to headed into the South State playoffs. Tonight also would have been the evening that we recognized our four Maroon Tide softball seniors and their families. These four young ladies have been a part of Maroon Tide softball for 6 years. They have truly seen the highest of the highs and the lowest of the lows. As freshmen, they played important roles on our South State championship team. As seniors, they saw their season come to an abrupt end. They did not know that the last game they played in a Maroon Tide softball uniform would be the last game they played in a Maroon Tide softball uniform. I've always said that kids are resilient. These four are no different. The question will not be, will they bounce back? The question will be, how high will they bounce? To the parents of these four young ladies, thank you. Thank you for sharing your daughters with us. Thank you for the loving homes that they come from. Thank you for your support. Thank Thank you for encouraging them after every game, after every practice, through every struggle, through every adversity, whether it be through life or on the softball field. They are stronger because of you. Thank you, parents, for what you will always mean to me. To these four softball seniors, I do not have to express in words what they mean to me or this program, because they know. So tonight, I recognize number 9, Jordan Hall. Number 12, Brooke Bro. Number 17, Morgan Dickerson. Number 18, Mary Beth Dowling. And tonight, we want them to celebrate with the Maroon Tide Nation, Maroon Tide softball fans, the Maroon Tide parents, their Maroon Tide teammates, what is their senior night. It might not be the same, but it is a celebration of you. We appreciate you. We look forward to seeing you again when that moment arrives. And we thank you for what you've given to this Maroon Tide softball team. Once a Lady Tide player, always a Lady Tide player. Roll Tide.